I'm Anthony Keenan, so I'm the supervisor at the Tuna Wastewater Treatment Plant. I've been supervising for about 3 months. Prior to that, an operator that includes standbys, there's various sampling, troubleshooting. Prior to that as well, I was a trainee and I've been in the job for 5 years. All right, so this is the Tuna Wastewater Treatment Plant in Dunedin, and Dunedin's population is about 130,000 people. This plant has flows from about three quarters of the city. We have the Green Island and Mosgiel plants as well, taking the remainder of it. And our daily flows are 25 to 30,000 cube. When it rains though, I mean, we can get over 180, 200,000 cubes. So this is a high rate activated sludge plant, which is really short retention time of 20 minutes. So this area is called HRAS, which stands for high rate activated sludge. And the tank is divided into three spots. So there's the grit chamber, the aeration tank, and then sedimentation. So the grit chamber removes all the rocks or stones that come through the screenings. And then the aeration tank provides air for the microorganisms. And then that goes over a weir to be settled out into the clarifiers. That is aided by a bridge which has scrapers that helps moves and even out the sludge just across the bed of the clarifier. And then we have the RAS pumps, which circulates around the sludge that is settled down to the bottom of the tank, and that joins in with the influent. Once we get to a set point of mixed liquor suspended solids, then the waste pump is activated. Then we have a secondary stage through the BTFs, and then UV treatment.
So this is UV, it's the tertiary treatment area. So it's the last line of defense before it gets taken out to sea. So basically what we're aiming for here is to treat the last of the effluent before it gets pumped out. And so what we take care of is E. coli, fecal coliforms, and enterococci. And so to achieve this, we have to have the most intensity we can get out of the UV lamps.
For our dewatering, we have GBTs, so gravity belt thickeners, and then it goes through a centrifuge, which gets our solids to about 35% dry solids. Then it gets stored into a hopper where we can either burn it.
All right, so this here is the fluidized bed incinerator, so it burns at 800 degrees. So we put through about 17 tons of sludge through that a day, aided by diesel to help burn it through sand, and it's fluidized through air, which aids the treatment of burning it. It goes up through the recuperator and gets cooled down by a scrubber, and the rest of the ash gets removed and the supernatant flow goes back through to the head of the plant.
Or we can send it to landfill. Currently we have a lime plant to stabilize the sludge, so to get rid of the odors basically, so we can place it at the landfill without too much disruption. So as an operator, we go through quite a few of the readings, like plant flows, you know, mixed liquors and UVTs. So basically just the water quality, and what it does is it travels through the plant, just trying to make sure that a lot of the BODs are getting treated and the solids are getting removed from the waste, and just trying to make sure that we produce the best effluent we possibly can to discharge out to sea. So we've got HRAS, which is sampling, sedimentation, aeration. And so we'll go in, we'll sample, we'll check the probes, the reading properly, and do a few tests in the lab, and then match it up with the current probes in there. All right, so this is the lab. This is where we take all the samples that we get from the inlet, from HRAS, from our biological trickling filters, and our UV system. So what we do is we do, from HRAS, the 30-minute settling. In the columns, we test the lab papers for the suspended solids by putting them through filter papers and cooking them in the oven. Then we do a pH, a temperature, DO, and conductivity test through the probes. And then we do a UV test through the spectrophotometer. And then we go through the microscope and check out the life of the microorganisms and the filamentous. Other areas like UV, so that's the last area before the waste gets discharged.
So this is daily. We go through and clean roughly about 6 of these modules daily, and anything else, so lamps or ballasts that need to be replaced will be also part of the tasks. You can see the caustic soda baths where we dunk them in for about 10 minutes, hose them down, then put it into the citric acid. Then we top up the gel and the grease in the wipers to make sure that they can clean when the auto wipers come on.
For dewatering, so that's when the solids get removed from the waste, there's centrifuging and GBTs, which is aiding the separation of the water from the solids, and that gets loaded up into a hopper. So the hopper can go 3 ways. It's either to the incinerator to get burnt.
What we usually do is, while it's running, we use the cooling sprays, which is on top. We pull them out to make sure that we're getting a good flow through. And then during shutdown, we clean out a lot of the pressure sensors, do a bit of greasing, and clean out a lot of the filters that the ash is connected to.
It's great. It's always full of challenges because no day is the same. So yeah, you change around different departments as well. It can be a bit frustrating with breakdowns, but it can also be great as well to troubleshoot these breakdowns and try to figure out what the problem is. It's quite a reward when you figure out an issue, especially if you figure out a problem by yourself. But there's a lot of people around here with a lot of knowledge and experience as well that you can ask to help out. Other times you can get about 20 minds together to try and figure out an issue and not get anywhere, but having that sort of unknown is part of the challenge too. And if everything was easy, then it would be boring. So yeah, that's the great side of it. It's good that you get a good balance between hands-on work as well as sort of admin work too. So we do a lot of readings. We're on the computer as well, like ordering tubes. So yeah, fair bit of study as well in there to exercise our minds, you know, keep us up to scratch. Even things like sort of microscope observations. Pretty cool to see those bugs floating around in there and eating away at the BODs.